At 6 o'clock I roll my truck out into the street. The morning sun is shining on the trash that I will meet. There's broken dolls and rubber wheels, TV sets and orange peels, baby rattles, paper plates, newspapers and rusty skates. Ooh, keep on trucking. Got to sort it, shred it, burn it to ash. There's a lot of hard work when you're working with trash. Take it to the terminal, dump it on a barge. Put it someplace that's awfully large. Ship it to a landfill where it decays. Cover it with dirt and make a park someday.
Transparent.
Yeah. Go ahead, bro.
I actually stepped out on my previous relationship also, and it was to a point where. I stepped out on my previous relationship, and so she found out on my laptop.
Oh my God! Wow! Oh my God!
Dang, I'm about to sound trash.
Go ahead, that's what's... Yeah, you go grab one.
Give me the trash bag. You got the first one.
You got the trash bag. All y'all trash.
But so
for this one segment, for that
dang, this is bothering me.
Yeah.
Go ahead. I'm with you, bro. We'll get there. It's nothing. Right there, support.
I stepped out foolishly because I had a great woman of God, but I stepped out foolishly and she found out on my laptop, and unfortunately, this wasn't the only case of stepping out that I did. So when she found out about the first one, it was like, yo, dang, like. Because we were still gonna be like, we was in the process of working things out. And it was like, but the other one, like I said before, like they'll eat away at you after, mm-hmm. after a certain point in time. I'm like, yo, I cannot continue lying with this girl. Like, it's like, there's no way I can move forward in this relationship if I don't tell her this. So, bruh, so she, and I'm praying all day, like praying to God, da, da, da. So I'm in my head, I'm like, yo, she asked me if there's anybody else, I gotta tell her, because I'm not lying no more. But she asked me, I just looked at my phone.
Yo, Holy Spirit be like, are you gonna do what?
Sorry.
Bro,
I will say, bro, if a girl asks a question, nine times ten.
She know the answer.
Yeah. Like, y'all know the answer. So us lying and just like.
When I seen that might have been the scariest text. I mean, not even scary, but it was just like, that joint touched my heart. Like my phone, like vibrated my heart. And, bro, I turned my phone off and I just was like praying all day. Like praying. To like 4 or 5 hours. I told her from my going. I wrote her this long behind message. Like, I told her the whole joint. I mean, after I definitely felt like relieved, but it was like, dang, G, now you gotta face all of this. Mm-hmm. You probably never gonna get shorty back. And so that's really be what it is. Like fear sometimes is a comfortable place. Mm-hmm. Instead of us facing like the truth and, you know, being transparent and exposed to what we've done wrong, you know, we'd rather just be in our comfort of fear, and that's kind of what we gain. It's a sense of comfort sometimes, and it's unfortunate because it's not the truth of comfortness, but
you're afraid of being vulnerable.
That's
an issue. To admit wrong is a big thing. Like, you know, to admit, say that we're wrong, like own up to it is like. Not the easy thing.
And especially as African, specifically Nigerian men, being vulnerable and having emotions
It's locked up like this.
It's tough. I love you don't come out too easy if I'm average.
Sure. Yeah. And when that hug's supposed to come, you scared a little bit.
You're like, oh, so you're trying to hit me.
Yo! That begs the question, though, for, you know, not to send you guys up, but you guys have the trash bags on your feet, so self-explanatory. But as far as, like, as Christian men, right? Because at the time we cheated, are we all Christians? Yeah. Or truly transformed? Young Christian man, at the end of the day, like, there's no shade to men who aren't Christian, but at the end of the day, God created us as males to be leaders, to be heads of households, to be accountable, to do all these things, right? But what is it that, you know, even as Christian men, that would have us step out? What led to that point where, I know I'm a Christian, I'm doing this thing, but now I want to go step out and cheat and do something that's wrong?
From a personal experience, I think that it's that love that you want to, not, I wouldn't say, that love of the world that that you want to experience as well. So, like, I was in a great relationship, these guys knew. And it was like from my freshman year in high school to like my freshman year of college, something like that. But yeah, I stepped out and I feel as though it was because I wanted to experience something I wasn't experienced with, you know, my woman God. So like it was different. It was different for me when I came back to myself like, yo, I really just stepped out and this girl is gonna be hurt because of it. So the consequences there that I had to face, you know, they weren't good. So at the end of the day, when we do that, when we as Christian men step out, I think it's for the fact that we just want to see what everybody else is seeing.
I'm not gonna let y'all classify Christian men as when we step out. Like,
oh,
nah,
not when.
In the rare instance that happens.
I know for me, like, I know, like, Lordy can touch this. I know, like, we've always talked about, like, for like the times when I'm not in my word and strong, that's when, like, I'm always like susceptible to do some like dumb stuff. Like,
yeah.
So around that time, it's like I was going through like a hard time in school, like just like trying to figure out, like, really just in a low place. So it's like I stopped reading my word as much, and like just like, you know, just like, you know, I don't want to care anymore. Like, even though like I still like love this girl, like, you know, I was like, but then it's like I went out to a party and boom, bang, it's like, it's one drink. All right, cool. Oh, this girl's talking. All right, cool. Like, and you're like, it just all leads up. I know, like, the worst part is like, especially after you do that, you're like, oh, let me run back to God. Yo, God, forgive me. Da, 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 da. Every Bible verse you read is like conviction. It's like, boom. Every Bible verse, like, and you're just like, oh, like, oh, God. Of course, you'll read, you know, there shall be no condemnation, but then you have to, like, if you read that whole thing, realize that, okay, there's no condemnation, but there's still a certain, like thing I have to do for myself. So, until, like, when I'm not in my word, and, like, I'm really more susceptible to do, like, stupid things. I mean, it's more so, like, with anybody, like, especially as a Christian, everyone has that, oh, that love, or, like, you know, that, or, you know, that constant, like, battle with the flesh. But it's, like, at the end of the day, like, the more that you're in your word, like, I'm not gonna say it becomes less harder, but it's like, it gets to a point where it's like what, a girl? Okay, cool, like, I have my girl. Why? Because, like, I know, like, our love is not based on, like, you know, what we see, but, like, the love of God, that's, like, holding our relationship, so. But, like, a constant, I'm in my word, you know? That's my thing, at least.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, from a perspective of Christian men specifically, I feel like a lot of times we might overestimate ourselves.
Because we are
Christians, so we feel like, you know, we forget that we still are like human who still have that same
mindset.
Like, you really gotta be in your word every day.
Yep.
You really gotta be with God every day to make sure that don't creep up back on you.
So, like, facts.
The moment you miss it, you put yourself in a compromising position. That mindset, you feel
it comes back.
Real quick.
I tell you what,
you wait for opportunity.
Yeah,
be thinking about the Bible when a girl is butt naked in front of you.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're not going to be thinking about no scripture to quote to
you're
her.
You're not Joseph.
It's not Joseph.
Also, no, but also real stuff, though. Let's go straight to Joseph.
Y'all can take our trash bags off. Oh, we know y'all trash.
You know, it's funny, when we were down, they said, you know, oh, you were in a down, you were, down place, you know, in a depressed state. The first thing we do is run away from God. That's the first thing we do when we're in a depressed or a sad state. And that's the complete opposite of what we should do. Yeah. You know, and when we eventually do come back to God, that conviction is there because he's like, yo, all right, so you already messed up. All right, but let me show you, yeah, what you did is wrong, but I'm going to bring you back up.
Yeah.
Like, I'm still here for you. I still love you. You know, so at that point, it's up to you. It's up to you what you're going to do with that. You know,
even from like just even human standpoint, like if you think about what happens after you cheat, like before you cheat, if you think, okay, if I do this and she finds out, how's this gonna play out? If you think about consequences, which I think we don't do a lot of times, we think about it afterwards, like, oh damn, now I gotta, how am I gonna break this to her?
Yeah.
If you thought about that before you were.
Before you did it,
put yourself in the situation you were in that made you do what you did. You might not, you might not do that. So if you're thinking like that, it'd be easier. I feel like as guys to like avoid doing those things.
Yeah, I think that you should always say this one thing, and I think I understand it now, since especially with my life. You said that as Christians, sometimes we always be like, how far can I walk to the left? How far can I walk? Like against the ledge without falling, instead of like, I'm gonna just stay away from the ledge.
Like, why, you know, we're over here
trying to tiptoe, and at the end of the day, it's like, yo, like, you literally, like, you have all this space over here. Like,
why you gonna walk on the ledge? For me, I feel like, it was like lust just going wild. And I feel like I've learned since then, that you can't really defeat a demon that you enjoy playing with. And I feel like lust is something that, like, I always say, like, all sin, I know all sin is judged the same and everything like that. Like,
is that demon attacking you right now?
All sin is the same. All sin is the same if you're a thief. But I always say, like, let's say thieves have 200 demons, killers have 400 demons, but I feel like lust is a billion. It's a billion of them. Like, it's a whole bunch of them.
Squad.
So, and I feel like it plays on our minds so much to a point, like, if you don't set a boundary up against it, then there's no way you're going to be able to defeat it. And I felt like I was in a place where I was just cool with it. I was just cool with being a lust. And it was like, it was crazy because I was still praying. I was reading my Bible and everything like that, but it was to a point where, like, I would just leave that part out. Like, I would pray about everything else in my life, but I would just leave the lust alone. It was something I was comfortable with. And I was cool with, you feel me? I was cool with it. So then, but after that, like, that was something that, like, now I know you can't even play. Like, it's your lust is so crazy, bro. Yeah, you really can't play with it at all, bro. It's like you could be doing one thing and you allow yourself to indulge in these thoughts, bro. Your mind is completely shifted into something. It's like, yo, how did I get here?
In my junior year, when I wouldn't say lost, but when I gave my virginity away, it was like, My teacher, I'm not
going to give you gave it to
you. You ain't trying to make
it. It was consensual.
I gave it.
But on a serious note, though, like, I remember my high school assistant basketball coach, Coach Charlie Brown. All right.
The Charlie Brown?
Yo. So basically, we had practice. I left. We had me and this girl had sex. We got caught in my friend's house. Then after that, came back to practice for the half day. But came back. Now the crazy thing, I don't know how, but my coach found out. I don't know how. So it could have been Holy Spirit, whatever.
Holy Spirit.
So anyway, he told me this, and this is something that I remember to that day, till this day. I'm sorry. The word. He said lust. You know, lust is a bug. And once that lust bug gets on you, it's hard to shake it off.
We didn't divert, but this is, everyone watching YouTube fam, the thing is, a lot of these questions that we're gonna be reading and the questions that have been asked and all the hurt in the relationship actually does spawn from lust. If you think about it, the desire for more, the desire for of your eyes, things that, you know, you see that you're chasing after, it causes you to abandon reason, it causes you to abandon what you know to be true, so you can gain this thing that you believe to be worthwhile, worth your time, valuable, to something that will give you back something that you feel like you're missing at the end of the day. And real quick plug, Heart of a Man movie. If you haven't seen that movie, it's called Heart of a Man. I'm going to plug a link in my bio to see that movie, to buy it, whatever you want to do, but you have to see that movie. An even better way to, and we talked about this at the Young Adults at Dig the other day, last week, how lust is like, I equated it to like a seed, right? Mm-hmm. So your body is the soil, right? Your body is things growing you, right? Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, lust is a seed, right? And seeds, what they do is they sprout out the seed, they take nutrients from the surrounding area, the ground around the soil. So whatever you're feeding yourself is what that seed is looking to grab and grow from. So if you're feeding yourself lust, if you're not taming your lust through reading the word, through renewing your mind, all that stuff, it's just growing, it's eating, it's getting strong. And then by the time you know it's a big tree in your life, and you're trying to cut down the tree, but it already has branches and things living in the branches, birds. So you got all these things, like, you know, multiplying because you didn't take care of lust in its infancy stages. At the end of the day, the truth is we are godly men. We are seeking after Christ. But the truth is, again, like, I don't know if it comes from other Christians or ourselves or the world, but at the end of the day, like, it's projected that we're supposed to be these infallible, untouchable, like, Marvel characters that can't be beat. No, like, for real, but at the end of the day, like, we struggle too. Like, at the end of the day, I don't think we definitely don't wake up in the morning like, dang, how am I gonna break this girl's heart today? How am I gonna break this relationship? I'm not editing that out.
You're a nice guy.
You're
my angel.
No such thing.
All right. Okay, why not just tell me the truth like you claimed you would instead of leading me on and involving my family?
That's
a
good
okay, now that's
the girl's fault for like bringing you around so quickly to the family, or is it like?
I mean, it doesn't necessarily have to be quickly though. I don't think she put a time.
You know, I got you. I answer that question because. I'm not gonna say the name, but when she was in college, I actually met like my girlfriend at the time. I met her parents and stuff, but I wouldn't say I was leading her on.
Yeah.
My intentions were, and still are, like whenever I get in a relationship, my intentions are long-term, marriage.
Yeah.
So I feel like a lot of people's mindset aren't there, but like it just didn't work out. Mm-hmm. I think I had a conversation with you about that too. I came from winter break and I was like, bro, like it's not going how I thought it would. Like it's, and I'm gonna sound like the weird guy, but I don't care. But for me, like, it was sex, but it seemed like the relationship was like just sex, and I want more. So I was like, maybe we should.
Was the sex coming from her, the demand for it, or coming from you?
Like, so it was mutual at first. Then, being like, when you have God in you, like, you always have that subconscious, like, all right, bro, you're doing a
Holy
lot.
Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Like, what you doing?
Yeah. So like, I'm sitting there like, I mean, it feel good. I mean, but I'm like, hey, let's cut this out. Let's try to build deeper outside of sex.
Right.
You know, that I think that started like springing issues, like, and then we started like arguing, like, oh no, you don't like me. You probably get to somebody else. I'm like, no. So I met her parents, but it didn't work out. But it wasn't me leading her on. You know what I mean? We just weren't clicking, I guess. Once I started like suggesting removing sex, that was started bringing issues. Like, yo, what's up? Why?
Did you tell her why you wanted to remove?
Yeah. Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah, I definitely explained to her, like, you know, I'm Christian, some thirst, like the whole nine yards. Like, I think we'll have a deeper connection if sex wasn't involved. Like, let's get to
that's real, ladies.
Let's get to know each other outside of sex. Even like, I'm not going. That's too much information. I'm not going to give you all that. But but like, yeah. Like, so I think like in a relationship, like you shouldn't involve sex so soon. Like
at all.
Actually, yeah. Let me say that. Like, I think you should wait till marriage. Like. Personally, it's hard to say that. So, I mean, but I think that's the right way to go. So I didn't start off that way, but I tried to get back on track. But that's ultimately what broke the relationship apart. Mm-hmm. So I met her parents and everything, going back to the question, but what's naturally leading on, you know what I mean? Like,
it just
didn't work out.
Yeah.
I said, man,
you knew better.
What you mean? Hey, this is like question statement. So do you not feel bad when you cheat on your girlfriend?
What?
Hey. Oh. In fact, rip it.
Not
even.
That's not us.
We met a God.
That's a whole other level.
That's a
demonic. That's a deep. That's a deep man.
Listen, this question,
We love you guys.
I feel very bad when I did have more time. It's not happening again.
A long time.
Never. Ever.
Because all things
mean you.
All things Christ. Christ.
Never going to happen.
Can you clean that up?
So one more question here?
Yeah. All right.
Dang, another.
Why do trash guys behave the way they do?
Because of y'all.
Yes.
Y'all want to know why? Because of y'all.
Hurt people hurt people.
Because don't say that.
Oh, that's the question we're going to
Hurt
people. Now let me tell y'all about her story.
Yeah,
okay.
We all
got
story.
Yeah,
we need the bag.
No, no, we need the bag for her. It's gonna symbolize y'all now.
Put that trash bag on there.
I was about 9th grade, 10th grade, high school.
That's when we were pure.
I mean, this is when I was pure.
Still pure.
Pure soul. Peaceful. Had a little shorty for me or whatever. We was rocking and. This one of the homies too, like this, he not my mans, but like when I see him, we're like, what's good? So I'm hearing through the hallways, like, yo, your shorty was in the hallway talking to such and such. I'm like, nah, she ain't gonna do me like that, bro. She ain't gonna do me like that. Bro, like a week after that, son, I see them on somebody's phone kissing and stuff like that. I'm like, yo.
Hey, yo.
I'm like, yo, you really out here doing me dirty? Bro, since then, after that, bro, I think I'm taking y'all serious after that. She the cause of a lot of destruction that was caused, you feel me? After that, I was like, yeah, nah, I'm not about to do me dirty, and I'm about to just be cooling after that. Now everybody else got to get it.
Did you reach, ooh, damn, okay. I was about to say, did you retaliate, but you said everybody
nah, else got to get it. Nah, I mean, not to her, but, you know, after that, I couldn't believe, I guess I didn't really know how to receive healing at the time. At the time, I didn't really know how to receive healing, so it was just me dwelling in the hurt and just reacting off of how my emotions was telling me to react. So instead of me, you know, being a mature Christian at the time, you know, just instead of going to God like, God, you know, just help me heal from the situation, like, yo, she did me dirty, like that. All these other girls, I'm doing them dirty too. And just, which is childish, but at the same time, like, you know, I wasn't really that mature, but she ain't have to do me dirty. Yeah. That would never happen. After that, I just started. That's when I started. Wow.
You want to say something?
Yeah, I'm just gonna, you know, chime in from a Yoruba angel's perspective.
Oh no,
they don't exist.
I've been hurt. Like, I've had a girl that I was like, yo, man, like, I'm really into this chick, and then like, she breaks up with me randomly, and then I find out. After we've broken up, that she's going on dates. You probably know what I'm talking about. Hey. She's going on dates.
Hey, I'm here.
She was linking up with like mad dudes. Like,
dang. That's really like, more than one dude is like, dang.
Like, lucky for me though, like, me and her didn't do nothing like
sexually.
Yeah, we didn't do nothing sexually. My thing is, I don't know, is it normal to like get hurt and then the response is to want to hurt? Because for me personally, like, when she cheated on me, that feeling was terrible.
Yeah.
No,
you wanted to, never wanted that feeling.
I don't want that feeling again. But also, like, I don't know. I'm empathetic in a way that I'm not gonna want to reciprocate that somebody, like, be with somebody and then put them through pain. You know what I'm saying? So like, what's the norm? Like, I feel like normally, like, as humans, let's not even talk Christian. As humans.
Humans, yeah.
Like. A human, like, you're not gonna like wanna inflict hurt on somebody else, even though you were hurt. You know what I mean? Like, say for example, you hurt him, and then because, wait, what did I say? Yeah, you hurt him. Mm-hmm. So because you felt hurt by him, you hurt me. So
yeah,
but I didn't do anything to you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So set tight, like.
At least for me, I don't think it's more so like after I get hurt, I intentionally say I'm gonna start hurting some other person. But I think it's just more so the experience changed something in me. Mm-hmm. And in that, I go and unintentionally hurt someone just by because of that change that was in me. Like for example, like in high school, this girl, I was rocking with her, like we was like talking deep, heavy, like, well, from my perspective, and it's like, from my perspective, I was so heavy.
Yeah,
like, she was probably just, I don't know. From my perspective,
I know exactly.
Yeah, I'm talking to her, I'm telling her things that I've never told anybody in my life before. I'm really opening up to her. I felt like she was telling me things she never told anybody before. And I was like really open myself up to her to really like have really deep feelings for her. And it was like intense. Like it was intense feelings. And back then I had no problem opening up because I never, you know, experienced a relationship before prior to that. So then I did that. And then the way it happened was like, so she know me and
Okay.
So basically,
she knows we're brothers.
She knows we're brothers. So she just stopped like texting me or hitting me up like the way she used to. I'm like, what's going on? So I don't know how, but I think I peeped in Valentine's phone. When Valentine came up to me, I was like, yo, why your girl like hit me up, whatever. I'm looking through the text messages. Yo, she texting them paragraphs. I'm getting like barely one texting paragraphs, emojis. I'm like, what's going on?
The emojis started so quick.
And then she flirted with him. So one time we was like, yo, let's set her up. And this was like, I think this was before like FaceTime was really popular. So we had hit her with the Skype, whatever. Boom.
No, ooh.
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 Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
So I was in the room with her. I was in the room, but she knew I was in the room, but Valentine was talking to her. He was like, yo, so da da da. So he talking nice to her, whatever, pretending. And then she just flirting with him, saying all this. I'm like, oh, and then she was like, so what about, like, then he asked, what about my brother? Like, you're gonna have to tell him. And she was like, oh, him? Like, oh, no, that was just a summer fling. And this is, from my perspective, I thought I was in love. I was like, she talking about
basura.
No, so that changed. I'm like, so that's how women are? So I'm like, oh nah, like I can't trust no other. Feel me? So that created that.
Gotcha.
So so ever since then, you can ask Valentine. Since then, it was very hard for me to be emotional with a girl again. So any like thing that I ever got involved in, I wasn't like, he knows like.
Yo, we went to vacation and I wasn't in Minnesota, bro. He had a girlfriend. Like it's not like, oh, you're talking about this is his girlfriend, and he'd be like. He didn't text her, I'm like, talk to her at all, like, the whole time, I'm like, bro, he said, yeah, I don't play talking to her. I'm like,
I'm like, bro,
that's your girl. He's like, yeah, I'm here.
What? Yeah, because like, I was just like, I was intentionally trying to do it, but it's just like, I literally couldn't open myself up to that, like, open myself up that way anymore.
Dang.
So it wasn't like I intentionally went on my way to hurt, but that just changed
like,
something.
Changed.
And I also feel like as guys, I feel like we're more, what's it called, fragile.
Yeah.
We're fragile. So the moment one thing happens to us,
women can't.
Man, the moment you see a girl hug another man.
I'll say one thing, like, we don't give ourselves enough time to heal.
Yeah.
When we go through a hurt,
yeah,
we jump to the next thing too soon.
Yeah.
And we carry that hurt and mess something up that could potentially
be good.
Yeah. Now they say, like, it's not just like timing is everything in relationships.
Yeah.
So you can be with the perfect person, but the timing isn't right.